I will talk about the production and performance evaluation of an encoder using a high-resolution magnetic encoder system on a chip. This is the encoder board I developed. I will briefly summarize the performance evaluation results and then explain in detail. I measured the accuracy of sensor boards using Onaxis magnetic encoder SoCs from two companies. One is the iCTW39 from iC-Haus and the other is a 12-bit resolution product from our company, which is widely used. The accuracy error ranges from approximately -0.067 to +0.078 degrees, so the accuracy of the encoder produced with the iCTW39 evaluation board is 0.078 degrees. As shown in the figure, there are two types of high-resolution magnetic encoders. The first is the off-axis type, widely used in precision robots. The second is the on-axis type, a widely used magnetic encoder type. Those who know about magnetic encoders will immediately sense that this is not for precision encoders. Currently, with the development of interpolator and magnetic resistance sensor technology, we can develop a 20-bit encoder using an on-axis magnetic encoder IC. I will introduce it to you. First, I will talk about the characteristics of the off-axis type magnetic encoder. Off-axis type magnetic encoders are used in collaborative robots and hollow structures. The magnetic scale has a magnetic polarity of several tens of cycles. The iC-Haus products, widely used worldwide, mainly have a magnetic scale with 32 or 64 pole pairs. An analog signal is output for each cycle of the magnetic pole pair, and by interpolating this by 14 bits, a magnetic encoder with a resolution of 19 to 20 bits can be developed. I will explain the characteristics of the on-axis magnetic encoder and demonstrate now. Since SoCs are sold worldwide by Infineon, Melexis, RLS, and iC-Haus, you can develop an encoder using SoCs. Up until now, on-axis type magnetic encoders have mainly had a low resolution of 13 bits or less. As magnetic resistance sensor technology has developed, the resolution for sensing magnets has increased, and currently, SoCs that output a resolution of 20 bits or more have been developed even with the on-axis type. Of course, even if the resolution is the same, the performance is lower than that of an optical encoder or an off-axis type magnetic encoder with a multi-magnetic pole. I will demonstrate the encoder characteristics using a 20-bit or more on-axis magnetic SoC for humanoid robots, BLDC servo motors, etc. The on-axis magnetic encoder SoC includes everything from the magnetic resistance sensor to the signal compensation processor, interpolator, and output processor. You can develop an encoder board by designing the power supply and output circuit with ease. This is the encoder board I developed. The board diameter is 9 millimeters and consists of a simple circuit. Today's test will use the manufacturer's evaluation board. The manufacturer recommends a magnet shape suitable for the IC, and you can use a magnet with a diameter of 4 mm or more that is suitable for the magnetic flux density required by the IC. I will demonstrate measuring the accuracy of a magnetic encoder using the iCTW39 evaluation board. This is a magnetic encoder SoC optimized for small BLDC motors applied to actuators of service robots and intelligent robots. In this video, I will review the accuracy measurement results at various speeds and compare the accuracy with another commonly used magnetic encoder product. The product name is iCTW39 and the product description is a 24-bit magnetic on-axis angle sensor. While most products use Hall sensors, the feature is that tunnel magnetoresistance TMR sensors are used to improve resolution and accuracy. As an on-axis type, it generates a one-cycle analog signal by sensing the magnetic resistance of a permanent magnet in one period per mechanical rotation and can interpolate it with up to 24 bits and output it as serial communication or incremental pulses. The test equipment consists of the iCTW39 evaluation board, a permanent magnet scale sold by iC-Haus, a high-resolution optical encoder as a standard for absolute position, and a jig and servo system for rotation. Accuracy was measured by comparing the two encoder signals using the synchrocissor, a dedicated encoder tester manufactured by iC-Haus. This is a rotating jig with a test encoder using iCTW39 and a reference encoder connected. The two encoders are connected using a coupling with low backlash, and since measurements are made while driving at a constant speed without changing direction, there are almost no errors caused by the coupling. The shaft of the servo motor and the axis of the two encoders are connected and rotated using a flat belt. The following video measures accuracy. While the magnetic encoder using the iCTW39 evaluation board uses one cycle of analog signals per mechanical rotation, the reference optical encoder outputs 4,096 cycles of analog signals, and has a built-in bearing to ensure accuracy. This is suitable as a standard for evaluating the accuracy of magnetic encoders. Let's measure the accuracy and jitter of the encoder using the iC-TW39 evaluation board. Before demonstrating, let us first briefly define accuracy and precision. The definition of this is defined in the following graph if you look at the ISO standards referenced on Wikipedia. Accuracy is how close a given set of measurements, observations or readings, are to their true value, while precision is how close the measurements are to each other. Precision includes repeatability, the variation arising when all efforts are made to keep conditions constant by using the same instrument and operator, and repeating during a short time period. What I measure in this video is accuracy. I measured accuracy while increasing speed from 500 to 3000 revolutions per minute. I measured about 2 minutes at each speed and played at 4x speed. First, this is the accuracy measurement result when rotating at 500 revolutions per minute. This is the result of measuring accuracy at a rotation speed of 1000 revolutions per minute. There is not much difference compared to when rotating at 500 revolutions per minute. In particular, the accuracy error did not increase particularly when accelerating from 500 to 1000 revolutions per minute. This is the result of measuring accuracy at a rotation speed of 2000 revolutions per minute. There is no significant difference when rotating at 500 and 1000 revolutions per minute. Lastly, this is the result of measuring accuracy at a rotation speed of 3000 revolutions per minute. Even if the rotation speed increases from 500 to 3000 revolutions per minute, there is no significant difference in accuracy. The accuracy error ranges from approximately -0.067 to +0.078 degrees, so the accuracy of the encoder produced with the iC-TW39 evaluation board is 0.078 degrees. Typically, the target accuracy of an Onaxis type magnetic encoder is 0.1, but it can be seen that it is very accurate. In particular, you can see that the accuracy does not change significantly even when accelerating. If you look at the jitter, it is about 0.8 small divisions on the y-axis in the graph. Since one large division is 0.088 degrees and there are 7 small divisions in one large division, the actual jitter is 0.088 divided by 7 times 0.8, which is about 0.01 degrees. The following are the measurement results of another company's Onaxis type magnetic encoder, which is widely used in robot actuators. What you need to pay attention to is that the iC-TW39's y-axis is -0.35 to +0.35, while the y-axis of the magnetic encoder for comparison is twice that of -0.69 to +0.69. The accuracy of magnetic encoders for comparison is about -0.25 to +0.26. Since the y-axis scale is half, the accuracy of the iC-TW39 is much better than looking at the waveform in the graph. If you look at the jitter, it is 0.025 degrees, about 2 small divisions on the y-axis in the graph. This is consistent with the iC-Haus results showing that the signal of the TMR sensor is approximately 2 to 4 times more stable than that of the Hall sensor. Until now, Onaxis type magnetic encoders have the disadvantage of causing vibration when driving the motor due to jitter and low accuracy of the encoder signal. For encoders using iC-TW39, the amount of vibration was reduced by about 60% and the accuracy error was reduced by about 70%, improving performance by more than twice. In addition to improving accuracy and vibration, the maximum resolution of prior Onaxis magnetic encoders is mostly 13 bits or less, but it can output up to 24 bits for serial communication and 18 bits for incremental. This can be applied to small joints of service robots, intelligent robots, etc. For additional information, please refer to the following video. It will be more convenient to watch the next video if you turn on the alarm settings. Thank you for watching.